My last deployment here was in November of 1990 in the United States Army Reserve out of Evansville, Indiana, with the 766 Transportation Battalion, stationed in Saudi Arabia, right there on the Kuwaiti-Iraqi border. My name is Master Sergeant Sherri Bishop. I work in the Commander Support Staff for the 136 Operations Group out of Fort Worth, Texas. I've been doing this job for probably 30 years. I was what they refer to as the battalion postal clerk. My job was to gather all of the outgoing mail and sort it. It was a four-hour drive to what they refer to as KKMC, take all the mail there, and then pick up all of the incoming mail for all of the individuals. We actually had a Patriot missile launch squad that was probably not even a mile from us that was there basically to protect us. After a while, you just get used to it. Stuff being blown up, or the ground shaking because you knew something got blown up. It just became part of your everyday life. You just learned how to cope with it. We would haul supplies, mail, water, equipment to the front lines. And then on their way back, they would pick up any outgoing mail from the frontline individuals, along with POWs and bodies, dead bodies. And they would bring them back into Saudi Arabia to the distribution places where we had to drop those individuals. When someone says, "Did I get mail today?" Their face kind of lights up if you tell them yes, but if you have to say, "I didn't see anything for you," you know, it's like their whole facial expression. I've seen a few people, I'm like, "No, you didn't get any mail today," and they'll be like, but mail definitely, just from looking at people's facial expressions, I think is a morale booster. It does affect the war effort in itself, because if someone else is having a bad day or anything like that, that can contribute over into, one, how do they fix the planes? How do they transport the equipment? Are they safe? Are they looking out for what they should be? Or are they thinking about what's going on at home? Why haven't I heard from home? 30 years later, it's easy. I mean, everybody has cell phones. 30 years ago, you stood in line at a tent for a 5-minute conversation with home. If you don't have the ground troops doing what they need to do on the ground, it makes it more difficult for the Air Force to do what they need to do in the air. It helps the crews and stuff be able to plan their missions and do them a little bit more safely.